top, Joshua Tree. So they're not too expensive, you know, it's around $10. So I would suggest you to get some lapis. It's completely worth having. You would want to probably put it in a necklace form. I've done that for my son. Or you can get a bracelet or anything, but raw is by far more, how do I say it, has more vibrational depth, frequency, than the one which has lacquer upon it. So try to get raw. The location that lapis comes from is Afghanistan. It's the only place in the world. There's a special cave in Afghanistan. And lapis is known in some ancient folklore as being the baseline throne of the creator of heavens, earth, and hell. Lapis is a truth stone, but it is also a money magnet. So if you can keep your lapis, it means you are one who is truthful. And your lapis is also one that attracts positive outcomes into your life. So some experiences that we've had with lapis, myself and my near relatives, is that when I was in Thailand, I had about 2 pounds of lapis in my bag. And so I was walking with that, and I went to the bank. I had to do some exchange, currency exchange. And the woman at the counter, she said to me, "Oh, this is the currency exchange." And I told her, "No, this is incorrect. You're not giving me a certain amount." And she says, "Oh, that is because I am keeping it." And I said, "What do you mean you are keeping it? Your company is keeping it? Who is keeping it?" "No, I am keeping it." I said, "I see. Then I'll take my business elsewhere. Thank you." While the other girl sitting beside her looked at her like this, and she even like couldn't believe what came out of her mouth. "Oh, thank you. Thank you, lapis." Because that's what happens when you have plenty of lapis. Other events which took place on this particular day when I had 2 pounds of lapis on me. I wanted to stay in a place that did not cost like $100 or $200 a night, American. So I was looking for something that was like 100 baht or less. I can't remember how much 100 baht is. Maybe it's like $3, $5, something like that. So I was walking up the street, and it's kind of a normal neighborhood for Thai. And so I asked one man, "Does he know any hotels up down that road?" And he said, "No, I don't know anything." And then I kept going. So I found a lady. She has a small shop outside her house. And I told her, "Hi, I'm looking for a hotel and around 100 baht a night or something." But she couldn't understand me. So she picks up her phone. She made a call to her friend from India. And he asked me what was it that I wanted to speak to her. So I told him. And then he informed her. And then he came back to me. She says, she told him to tell me, go ahead and stay in her home. So I said, "Oh yeah, absolutely. How much would it be?" She said, no, it's free. You are my guest." So I stayed with her for about 2 or 3 days, and I got to know her family and relatives, and they were just really wonderful. And again,